we move ahead a little bit more than 200 years now and move from northern Germany, where the organs were very clean and very transparent, and where the magic of the organ was the fact that you could play multiple voices and have them all come out sounding like pieces of equal pieces of a puzzle. Now we move into France and a completely different way of looking at the organ as a symphonic instrument, as an organ with a broad, rich carpet of tone and with enough of the fiery reed sounds to equal or actually surpass the electricity and the power of the symphony orchestra. These instruments were designed to be in large resonant rooms, Gothic spaces, so the organ had room to roll around in it. The champion of this school of organ building was Aristide Cavaillé-Cole, and he found one of his champions in the composer César Franck, who was in a very fashionable church, not even the cathedral, but a parish church in Paris, the Church of Saint Clotilde. Franck arrived at this church at the same time that Cavaillé-Cole built not his largest instrument, but one of his finest. And Franck wrote a small body of work, but he wrote it with these organs in mind. The piece I'm going to play for you now is probably the most famous of his. It's called the Pièce Héroïque, or Heroic Piece. This was not written for the church at Saint Clotilde, but rather for a new Cavaillé-Cole organ in the concert hall at the Trocadéro in Paris. And it has everything that you would expect to find on a rich symphonic organ, exploited to the max. So this is Franck's Pièce Héroïque.
Thank you.
of the great glories of Chautauqua, of course, is the Smith Memorial Library. I was in there last week, and there's a couple working in there who are fairly recently married, and the woman looked at my card, and she said, "Oh, you're the organist that's going to play." I said, "Yes." She said, "Would you please play the trumpet voluntary?" And I said, "Well, I hadn't really planned to put that on the program." And then her husband came over, and he said, "Play the trumpet voluntary, or we'll take away your library card." So to keep peace over at Smith Library, here is, in point of fact, what everybody calls the trumpet voluntary, but we now are pretty sure that it was not by Henry Purcell, but by Jeremiah Clark, and it's the Prince of Denmark's March. I know because you're on summer vacation that you've been praying for hot weather, but we've been praying for cool weather so the organ would be in tune, and it was in tune well enough for the trumpet voluntary. So that puts you in a nice frame of mind to listen to a piece of very exotic music, I think. I always try to include on every program something written in my own lifetime. This piece makes it under the wire because it was written in 1957. This is called The Burning Bush by Herman Berlinski, who is a Jewish composer. This is a wonderful story in sound of the argument between Moses and God that starts the Jewish Exodus. You may remember from your Old Testament, the beginning of the book of Exodus, that Moses was tending sheep for his father-in-law, and he came around the corner of the mountain one day, and there was a bush that was beginning to burn but not being consumed. And so Moses realized this must be a holy place. So he approached the bush, and he said, "Who or what are you?" And out of the bush, the voice of the Lord said, "I am who I am." Now, in Hebrew, this is Ahie, Asher, Ahie. And the rhythm of that, bum-bum-bum, bum-bum, bum-bum-bum, is the germ for this piece. You will hear the beginning of the fire, the flames crackling and getting higher and higher and higher, and then out of the flames, you will hear this mystic voice in the organ saying, "I am who I am." When Moses finally gets over his shock, he said, "What can I do for you?" And God says, "Well, I'm going to have you lead my people out of Egypt and into the promised land." And Moses begins to have an argument with God, which is probably not a very good idea. And he says, "Well, you know, why me?" And God said, "I am who I am." And Moses said, "Well, I really am not a very good public speaker." And God says, "I am who I am." And Moses said, "Well, nobody's really going to pay any attention to me. I'm just a sheep herder." And God says, "I am who I am." And finally, Moses said, "Well, it's really, can't you find somebody else?" And God says, "Well, your brother Aaron is really better for this than you are." And that gets Moses' goat. So he finally says, "Okay, I'll do it." So it ends with this apocalyptic struggle between these two wonderful personalities. And then at the end, what may very well be the loudest chord you will ever hear from this instrument. So this is The Burning Bush of Herman Berlinski. You probably won't go home tonight humming this tune. But I hope that you take this as a picture in sound. I always tell people when I have modern music on programs, I said, you don't have to like it, but I would like you to listen to it at least once, and then you can form an opinion. So feel free not to like that piece, but now you've heard it. Seth Bingham was an American composer, somewhat underrated, I think. He wrote a fair body of music in the 1930s and 40s. Much of it doesn't get played anymore, but I was searching for the right piece for this little spot on the program, and I came across this little piece called Roulade, which is like a little scherzo or a dance. And this uses all kinds of things with the organ. It gets loud, it gets soft, it's fast, it's slow, it plays with various sounds and colors, and it's basically just fun. So this is the Seth Bingham Roulade.
Thank you.
What you heard was what we believe is the world's largest player organ. Part of the renovation of this organ was to install digital circuitry, microcomputers that are run by a floppy disk, just like you put in your home computer. And it is possible to record a complete performance on this floppy disk and then play it back whenever you feel like it. No one's tried this before this summer, so we thought we would do this and give you an idea of how that works. It's very weird to be sitting down there and watching all the stops flip in and out and hear your performance come back, so I'm not sure that I'll be doing that too much. Staying in the same vein as of American music, this is a concert piece by Edwin Lemaire. He was an Englishman but transplanted to the United States. For a good long time, at the beginning of this century, he was the highest paid organist in the world. He did a series of concerts in San Francisco. He was a municipal organist of Portland, Maine, and of several other cities. He left a large body of music which was pretty much forgotten in the 60s and 70s and has all been republished, and organists like myself are busy relearning it because we think it's great stuff. This is a concert piece in the form of a polonaise, which is a Polish dance that has a lot of stomping in it, so enjoy this. The two men who brought this organ to life are sitting right down here in the second row. Would you stand so we can acknowledge what you've done for us at Chautauqua? This is Paul and Mark Fisher. Last year I had some good luck with music of John Philip Sousa, so I'm going to do some more for you to close this part of the program. 3 weeks ago I was in France on a tour with my church choir, and we sang and I played in a church in Rouen, and I closed the program with the Washington Post March, which I played last year. I wasn't sure exactly how they were going to take this in Rouen. The organist came up afterwards, and through his translator he said, you know, this church was built in 1241, and the organ case was done in 1567, and in 1940, we even survived three bombs, which went off right at the front of the church and nearly demolished it. We weren't quite ready for John Philip Sousa.